The Jersey Devil is a creature that has been sighted many times over the past few centuries on the east coast of the United States. It is said to inhabit areas around Gloucester and Salem counties in southern New Jersey, although reports have come from all along the east coast, including some in Pennsylvania and southern New England. The story of the Jersey Devil dates back to 1735, when Mother Leeds, a Quaker woman, was desperate for money to support her children, so she sold her soul to Satan in exchange for wealth and prosperity. Others believe that this creature might have been created by witches, and some think that it might be an alien or just an imaginary entity. Whatever it is, no one really knows what the Jersey Devil really is. Mother Leeds had 12 children, and then gave birth to something that was not human. It was said that she gave birth to a 13th baby at home, and then threw it into a fire thinking it was dead. The baby survived, but with red eyes and hooves for feet. It grew up into an ugly creature with horns on its head and wings on its back, and terrorized the Leeds family for 13 years before vanishing mysteriously. One night, she lured some men into the woods, only to reveal herself as a hideous creature with horns and wings. The Jersey Devil has been blamed for many strange events since then, including livestock kills and grain mill failures. After Mrs. Leeds died, her ghost was said to haunt the woods near her farm. It was first officially reported as a true story in 1909 by John Van Dyke, a Princeton University professor. It has been a part of popular culture since then, with mentions in books, television shows and movies, as well as an amusement park attraction. John Van Dyke first heard about the Jersey Devil from his mother's nursemaid when he was 9 years old. He published what is now considered to be one of the earliest accounts of the Jersey Devil. The creature that has been seen by people in South Jersey for hundreds of years. In 1813, Napoleon's brother Joseph Bonaparte, the former King of Spain, lost the throne and relocated to America. He spotted the beast one winter. He heard about the Jersey Devil story when he moved to New Jersey. He was left alone in this country house during the winter, so he decided to go hunting in the woods on his property. He noticed unusual tracks in the snow, unlike anything he had ever seen before. They resembled donkey hooves, but instead of 4 feet, there were only two. He then turned around to see a massive creature with the head and wings of a horse. It shrieked and swooped down on top of him. He told everyone he knew about the incident, swearing it was the Jersey Devil. People who lived in the Pine Barrens in the 1800s were known as Pine Rats, because they were often found living in cabins in the middle of nowhere, scavenging for supplies whenever they could. They're now known as Pineys, or simply Rednecks. Moonshiners, criminals on the run, and draft evaders were all found in the woods. During the 1800s, they told a lot of terrifying stories about local folklore. As a result, villagers were particularly hesitant to venture out into the woods after dark for fear of seeing the Jersey Devil. Hannah Butler, according to an article in the Atlantic Monthly, was drinking a strong apple cider known as Jersey Lightning, and as a result, she overcame her fear of walking in the woods at night. She went out one day and heard the Jersey Devil's blood-curdling screams. She came face to face with it. It had black fur and hooves, according to her description. It had the face of a horse or a goat, but it only had two legs and enormous leathery wings. Members of the Navy were conducting maneuvers at the Hanover Mill Works, in the Pine Barrens in 1909. They were practicing firing cannons, according to a Navy commander named Stephen Decatur, when they noticed the Jersey Devil in the distance. They claimed to have even fired a cannonball at the beast. Witnesses said they saw the cannonball strike the Jersey Devil directly in the face, yet it was still alive. When word of this story spread, people couldn't help but believe it was true, because it came from the Navy officials. The general public became much more terrified. Over 1,000 people have reported seeing the Jersey Devil to the police. In the villages around the Pine Barrens, school was canceled. In 1927, a cab driver in Salem City, New Jersey, had a flat tire in the middle of the night. It was years before electric street lighting, the streets were pitch black, and the Pine Barrens woodlands would have surrounded him. He stepped out of the car to change the tire, but the horrible beast appeared, screeching and screaming, and tried to attack him. The driver climbed back inside the car, but the Jersey Devil was bashing on the car's roof, as if attempting to get inside. The cab driver who claimed to have seen the Jersey Devil reported the event to the authorities. In 1972, while traveling down Greentree Road, a long road that spans across numerous communities in southern New Jersey, in her rearview mirror, a woman named Mary Ritzer Christensen was driving from Blackwood to Glassboro when she noticed the creature crossing the street. The animal was around 25 feet away from her car's back. Like a goat, it had shaggy haunches, but it stood like a man. Greentree Road does not travel through the Pine Barrens, despite the fact that it is surrounded by trees. The Jersey Devil, according to those who believe in its existence, was born in the Pine Barrens but has the ability to travel to other sections of New Jersey. Christensen informed everyone she knew about the creature she saw that night, and her story was eventually published. The Batstow Village, which has been intact since the 1700s, is located in the Wharton State Forest, which is located in the heart of the Pine Barrens. Alan McFarlane, the chief forest ranger, was dispatched to a South Jersey farm in the Wharton State Forest in 1980. The farmer's entire pig herd had been mercilessly killed in the dead of night. As though something had sat on their backs, the backs of each pig's head had been eaten. The pig's backs were clawed, but whatever killed them didn't harm the rest of the body. The regional animals do not often attack in this manner. Chief McFarlane stated he has never seen anything like that in all his years of service. The mystery has remained unsolved to this day. Locals believe the only reasonable explanation for this occurrence is that it was committed by the Jersey Devil. In 1993, John Irwin, a forest ranger, was monitoring the Mullica River, which runs through the Pine Barrens of New Jersey. He was driving when he had to pull over due to a large animal in the center of the road. He described it as having thick, matted black fur with horns, just like the devil. It was more than 6 feet tall. Irwin stared at it for several minutes. Because this was before the invention of cell phones, John Irwin would have had no way of capturing any proof. He didn't dare to move his car since he was concerned it might attack him. The creature returned to the woods after a few moments. The Smithville Inn's proprietor, Fran Coppola, came outside one night to empty the inn's trash cans behind the building. When she raised her eyes, she noticed the shadow of a winged creature looming above her. She was calm, and instead of fleeing, she just stood there staring. She had the impression that the Jersey Devil was guarding the inn, and protecting it like a guardian angel, rather than attempting to attack the guests. Fran Coppola confesses that she believes in the Jersey Devil, and that she was thinking about the legend the day she saw the shadow. She swears it's true, and she even went on camera in a documentary on the Jersey Devil to substantiate it. Route 9 is an important highway that runs alongside the Pine Barrens, and it is used to travel to the Jersey Shore. A story from someone going by the name of Sonny Z was one of the many sightings reported. It was around 10 p.m., and Sonny was driving through the town of Bayville, he wrote, when a hideous thing emerged from the woods. Two automobiles in front of him had to slam on their brakes. According to him, it was hairless, with odd small ears and hooved feet. He also claimed it stood nearly 10 feet tall, towering above the road. He claimed it resembled every famous drawing of the Jersey Devil he'd ever seen, and that it galloped across the highway at great speeds. Several people claimed to have seen the Jersey Devil along Route 9, in Egg Harbor Township near a golf course in 2015. The witness David Black thought a llama was standing inside its fence along the highway, until it quickly popped out enormous wings and flew away. David Black took out his phone and attempted to record a video of the creature. The video clip is only a few seconds long, but it depicts what looks to be the Jersey Devil soaring across the screen, a dark silhouette against a vibrant sunset. David Black is also credited with a still photograph of the same monster. So what do you think of the Jersey Devil? Let us know in the comments below, and as always, please like and subscribe.